Squad.
Tonight, I hope you brought your journals. Also, I hope you grabbed a Bible as well. You're gonna be needing that tonight. Let's just jump right into it. As you can see right here, we are in the haves and the have-nots series. This series is all about talking and focusing on what you have rather than focusing and complaining and worrying about what you don't have. And so far we have discussed that no matter who you are, where you're from, what you look like, what you've done, you've got a past, you've got a present, and so tonight is all about the future. We are also continuing to focus on the best question ever. Now that was back from a couple weeks ago at R Squad Live, the best question ever, which is, in light of my past experiences, my current circumstances, and my future hopes and dreams, what is the wise thing for me to do? We've talked about being wise in the past and in the present, but maybe you're kind of scratching your head like, how do I be wise in the future? I can't get to the future. The future's like over there. I'm in the present right now. How do I be wise in the future? I don't really understand that. Well, here's our question for the night. Maybe you want to write this down. Have you ever wanted to see into the future? I wonder what I'm going to look like in the future.
Let's test it out. All right, we're going to use that. Let's see here.
Yeah, all right. Anyways, you know, humans do so much to try to predict and plan out the future, right? We get calendars and we get notebooks and we write down all of our plans and our hopes and our dreams, but the future is unpredictable. It's a little scary. A couple years ago in college, I wanted to see into the future. I had all these plans about how I thought things were gonna happen, how it was gonna work, and it just wasn't happening. I had like no money in my bank account. I didn't have a car. I was walking to and from work in the pouring rain slash snow in the middle of the winter. That is until I got fired from my job. And around that same time, actually one day while I was walking to work, I had been in contact with this church about getting an internship. I thought that it was working out. We were good to go. Things were gonna be looking good. And all of a sudden at the last minute, they called me and they backed out and they chose somebody else. I just couldn't see the future plan. I thought things were gonna go maybe the way that I wanted to after I had been in a tough season, but then it just all went downhill. I didn't understand it. I was trying to make sense of all of this and try to figure out what does my future look like, because I can't really see it. And I bump into a challenge that every person in life comes across at some point in time. It is the challenge to trust God with tomorrow, because He is the only one who knows what tomorrow holds. Now, as humans, we don't really like this answer a whole lot. We don't love it because we like to control stuff. We like to make sure that the outcome we want is the outcome that happens. Such is the case with our boy Moses that we've been talking about over the past couple of weeks. Moses is the kind of guy who, like all of us, doesn't really want to get into anything or commit to anything unless he's 100% sure and certain about how the outcome is going to be, about what the future holds. But God is continually inviting him to trust the only one who knows what tomorrow holds. Now, we certainly think and trust and hope that God has our best interests in mind. The Bible says that several times, that God wants to take everything about us, work it all together for good. And we believe that God is good and that he's going to do that. However, the Bible also talks a lot about planning for the future. The Bible also talks a lot about how to be wise now as you consider and think about your future. And so we're going to look at some stuff today that the Bible talks specifically about making decisions and wise living and thinking as it pertains to what is in our future. Proverbs is a book filled with wisdom. Let me read you some of my favorite verses from Proverbs, and we'll talk a little bit about how we can apply these to life. Proverbs 14 says, "The simple believe anything, but the prudent, or the wise, give thought to their steps." And another one of my favorites, Proverbs chapter 10, verse 17 says, "Whoever heeds discipline shows the way of life, but whoever ignores correction leads others
astray.
So we've got a wise person who considers his steps. And then we also have, right here, the Bible talking about paying attention to discipline in your life shows you the way or the path to life. Here's what these two verses and so many other verses in the Bible, in Proverbs, are trying to get at. This is it right here. You're going to want to write it down. Your decisions are connected. Your decisions are connected. Your decisions are connected. This is also true right here. My decisions today impact my tomorrow. It's a pretty big deal. My decisions today impact my tomorrow. The Bible says a wise person gives thought to his steps. And then in Proverbs 10, it says, whoever heeds discipline, pays attention to discipline in their decisions in life, they have the pathway to a successful, a healthy, the best life imaginable. I gotta give thought to my steps today. Today isn't really that far from tomorrow. We're only one day apart. So if I'm not the type of person that I want to be today, if I'm not making the types of decisions that I want to make today, what types of decisions am I going to make tomorrow? They're probably going to be pretty similar. Do you see how that works? So if I'm wanting to be someone else in the future, if I'm wanting to do something else in the future, how do I see into the future? Well, I really take a look at and examine my decisions today. This is something that you should say every single morning when you get up out of bed. My decisions today impact my tomorrow. All right. When we talk about the future, I always feel like it's connected to what we're gonna do. What are we gonna do in the future? Where am I gonna go? Am I gonna have a family, this job or that job? Am I gonna have kids? What school am I gonna go to? Am I gonna get this car or that car? Am I gonna be successful? It's always connected to what I wanna do in the future. But the Bible doesn't really talk a whole lot about how to get your dream job or what you're going to do specifically as it pertains to your work or your family situation or where you're gonna live for the rest of your life. What it does talk about though is who you should be. I'm in a cloud of smoke because my fire's dying, but here's something cool to think about. Who do you want to be? This is your character. We all know somebody who, because of their skill or because of hard work or because of whatever they did in order to get to the top, they were successful. They made it. They were living their dream. But unfortunately, I feel like we also know some people who made it to the top, but because of their character, because they didn't pay attention to who they were becoming, they got to the top, but eventually had a failure that took them to the bottom. This is because when people think about the future, they only think about what they want to do, not who they want to be. I tried. So we've talked about how our decisions are connected, how they're not only leading me to do something in the future, but they're also leading me to become someone in the future. So the question for you is, who are you becoming? What are your decisions that you're making right now say about the person that you're going to become in the future? Because if all our decisions are connected, our decisions and our habits are the things that we are becoming. What could your life look like in 2020, in 2025, in 2035? What could it look like? So the best question ever, in light of your future hopes and dreams, what's the wise thing for you to do? You have a future. You don't just have a past and present, you have a future. And with God, your future is really bright. But the question tonight is, who are you becoming? If you look 5 years down the road, 10 years down the road, 20 years down the road, what are your decisions today saying about the person that you're becoming and will become in the future?